मोशन मूव्ड श्री विवेक के तनखा, आपकी पार्टी से दो वक्ता हैं, 24 मिनट समय है, आपस में आप।
लेट मी थैंक द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर गिविंग अस सर्टेन फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स, बट आई स्टार्ट विद अ कैवियट दैट इट्स नॉट अ बिल विच इज प्रोटेक्टिंग द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ 344 मिलियन पीपल, बट इट इज अ बिल विच इज नाउ going to deeply enter the pockets of 344 million people. Why? When in India today we have 18 international airports, 7 custom airports, 78 domestic airports, and 26 civil enclaves and defense airports. I mean, I could be wrong with one or two. From the regime of Airport Authority of India, we shifted to the next regime of this AERA. Now, this is a regulator. Why did we shift? We shifted because Airport Authority of India was doing a dual function. It was an operator and a regulator. Now, when operator also becomes a regulator, there's a problem because there's a mismatch and there are conflicts. So in 2003, when government started thinking of privatization, that's the time this process also began. And finally resulted in a regulator being born. But the problem that I face is that by amending the definition of a major airport, you are reducing the reach or the jurisdiction of a regulator and handing it over to private entities. Now, how do you hand it over? You hand it over through a bid which is for 20 years or 25 years. Now, I am, as a public, as a consumer, I am not aware of what provisions are being made to govern recovery of tariff and recovery of fee from a bid document. Because the bid document is between the government or the airport authority and between the private operator. Now, the question is, why did you bring a regulator? You brought a regulator because you felt that money which has to be taken from passengers who enter the airport, and this money is for under two heads, what you call the aeronautical charges and what you call the fee. Now, if you are going to recover money on these two charges, and these charges are also variable, and these charges also need to be revised reviewed every 5 years, now who is going to do this in public? If you hand it over to a private entity, I don't know for 25 years that private entity is going to be the master of that airport. How these charges, which a fee means also a quid pro quo, what they will charge, whatever they are going to spend. So 25 years beforehand, you are going to decide for what, how much they are going to charge for 25 years, and who regulates? A regulator is by nature an independent authority, an independent body. Why do we have regulators everywhere? So I am saying that a regulator is not an antithesis of privatization. In fact, a regulator helps privatization because you have to have a level playing field. If you don't have a level playing field, then people in authority would have, would do what they want to do. And today, so often we see in courts cases being filed by consumers, By people who are commuters, who go to court and say, sir, this fee is excessive. This is not the service they are rendering. This could not have been charged. Now, if it is part of the bid document, then you are rendering this entire act, OCOs, for major number of airports. Now, today about 31 airports come in the category of major airports. Now, those 31 airports, out of that, I think immediately because of the change of definition, they will now cover only 14. So rest of the airports you are leaving to the private, to the dictates of either airport authority or private operators. Because where there is no private operator, there would be airport authority. Now airport authority was diluted by this act only because you didn't want airport authority to do that function. But that's a separate function. So there's a dichotomy in this provision, that either you are leaving it to a private operator or you are leaving it to airport authority, both of which was against the objects of this act. So this amendment by itself, what I feel, does not subserve consumers' interest, at least. And I can give more arguments. If you see, why not improve the capacity of ERA? Instead of saying that the ERA will not be able to do its job in so many airports, you improve the capacity of AERA, ERA, so that they can perform a better job in all the airports. Rather than improving that, we are diluting it, my lord. Then another thing I would like to say, when you frequently, now what happens tomorrow, today this airport is not a major airport, by the definition. Tomorrow it becomes a major airport after 5 years. Today the definition is 1.5, earlier the definition was 15 lakhs. Now it is 35 lakhs footfall. Now if I from 20 lakhs, I became 35 lakhs tomorrow, or day after tomorrow, or after 2 years or 4 years, then you'll again change the regime. So I don't know how many times you're going to change this regime. Why not have one regulator for all airports? And what is he doing? I mean, Section 13, if you look at Section 13, you are diluting Section 13. Section 13 essentially, it is not a question of the definition, it's dilution of Section 13. Section 13 says, functions of the authority. The authority shall perform the following function in respect of major airports. So by diluting that, you reduce the number of airports. And what are the functions? To determine the tariff for the aeronautical services taken in consideration, the capital expenditure incurred in timely investment improvement of airport facilities, service provided, its quality and other relevant factors, cost for improving efficiency, economic and viable operations of major airport, revenue received from services other than aeronautical services, concessions offered by the central government in any agreement or memorandum of understanding or any other factor which may be relevant for this purpose. And the second part which is get covered is B, to determine the amount of development fee in respect to major airports, to determine the amount of passenger service fee levied, to monitor the self-performance standards relating to quality, continuity and reliability of services as may be specified by the central government, to call for such information as may be necessary to perform such other functions relating to tariff. Now, fee, Supreme Court, and we all know by law, is a quid pro quo. You can't charge more than what you serve. You can't charge more than what you give. Now, if under a bid document, you're determining a fee, is it a quid pro quo? Where is the measure? And how will it, if it increases, how will it increase? We don't know. That's private. That's a private agreement. So what you have actually done, by taking away a regulator from the majority of airports, you're handing over the task to either a private agency or to an airport authority maybe, which used to do it earlier, but was a mismatch and its interest conflicted with as an operator and as a regulator. So I'm strictly of the view that looking to the objects of this act, this amendment actually goes against the objects of the act. What you are doing is reducing and diluting the role of a regulator, and nowhere in the world the role of a regulator is being diluted. In fact, everywhere it is being enhanced, whether it's electricity, whether it is water, whether it is anything else. Regulators are today regulating most of the commodities or most of the services, because there has to be an independent agency. If we don't do that, and if we carry on with this bill, you are in fact finishing this act, bringing a new regime where this act will have no value. We will have no control. What is going to be charged as fee and what is going to be charged as tariff is something which will be beyond our control. Thank you.
Thank you.